Today I'm going to be talking about the GTX 950 and whether or not it's still worth gaming on. If you're on a budget, you may be considering the GTX 950 for your gaming rig. But is it still worth it when there are so many newer, more powerful graphics cards on the market? Today we're going to find out. I started off pretty light with Rocket League. I'm running the 950 with a 5600X and 16GB of RAM. And you can see, even in Rocket League, this little card is maxed out. We are still getting an average of 132 frames per second, with graphics settings set to high quality. Even with a max power draw of only 90 watts, this card sat around 72 degrees Celsius. Next, I booted up PUBG and it loaded with everything set to very low or low settings. Frame rates were still above 100, averaging 118 frames per second at the end of the test. The 950 was maxed out and ran a little hotter in the mid 70s. Now it's time to put the 2GB of GDDR5 memory to the test. Let's boot up Red Dead Redemption 2 and we can't even play at 1080p. The memory is maxed out. No worries, we can still try and play at 720p. Even with everything set to low, we're getting a warning that it's still using more memory than we have available. Let's give it a go. Actual gameplay wasn't too bad, but I did have the warning repeatedly pop up saying that the system is running low on memory. Settings are already at their lowest, so the solution really is a better graphics card. I had a feeling that the 2GB of memory was gonna hold this card back. After 30 minutes of gameplay, the 950 averaged 42 frames per second at 720p low settings. I wouldn't call this an enjoyable experience, and the game crashed at the end and did this. After that seizure-inducing experience with Red Dead Redemption 2, let's see if Cyberpunk 2077 does any better. The 950 was able to handle 1080p. I ran the game for 40 minutes, and the 950 saw an average of 36 frames per second and was maxed out the whole time. I did see a low of 17 frames per second, so while playable, it wasn't the best experience. Finally, I wanted to test Modern Warfare 2. I set graphics quality to the minimum preset and turned off film grain. I also adjusted the field of view to 105. The minimum recommended graphics card is a GTX 960, and the 950 did better than I thought it would. Like we've seen, the 950 was maxed out in this game. The 5600X got a nice little break today. I was able to get a few kills with an average frame rate of 69 frames per second by the end of the test. In a game like this, you want the highest frame rates possible. Well, not the best, above 60 frames per second on average is pretty good. Overall, the GTX 950 was the best at esports titles. I wasn't really surprised by that. If you are just looking to play esports titles and some older titles, this card could certainly get you by, but it's not really going to do much for you in modern AAA titles. At the time of recording, it's going for $40 to $60 on eBay. I have a hard time recommending the 950 when just $20 more could get you the RX 588GB at $80. You'd have a much better experience. So overall, I would not recommend playing on the GTX 950 anymore. If you enjoyed this video, check out my RX 580 review and subscribe if you haven't already.